So tonight we're going to talk about Roe versus Wade being overturned. I know it was a short notice. I'm going to give people a little bit of time to get in here. And then we just going to get it in. All right. Y'all come pull up. Let everybody know we here. I'm going to play a song. Y'all know how I do it. And then we're going to get to work and talk about exactly what the hell is going on in America. 3Ks Don't Get This Shit Fucked Up Incorporated, and why there seems to be so many people confused, angry, upset, and scared.
When I lay this blaze, I melt down cracks, that's reels and slaves. Hit the studio, jars and dro, bars the blow. BC go with that arsenic flow. Fuck that, don't hold me back. I'm over crack. Y'all cats told Mac the rat. Y'all don't realize y'all release the beast untamed. Speech all flame, streets all blame. It should be an honor for y'all to speak my name. I could go before your honey, could beat my name. Gotta laugh, don't act like you spit it the same. Why you motherfuckers can't get in the game? I come from high school and go straight to the league. Who you know what the spit it with seed? Yeah, nigga, truth. Every time I step in the booth, I speak the truth. Y'all know what I'm bringing to you. I bring the truth. You motherfuckers know who I be. I be the truth. When I speak, self set you free. Nigga, the truth. Every time I step in the booth, I speak the truth. Y'all know what I'm bringing to you. I bring the truth. Motherfuckers know who I be. I be the truth. When I speak, self set you free. And I can change the seed. I'm still stuck in the kitchen. So outside, that's fine. Still stuck in position. You motherfuckers know me well. Couple court cases from jail. Couple 404 shells from hell. Stuck on this mission. Go home, my girl fussing and bitching. Motherfucker, won't you change your life? I'm thinking. Motherfucker, won't I change my life? Ignorant bastard, laughing like fuck the rap shit. It's just another hustle, another way for niggas to touch you. Now they know the face of beans. Now they see my face on screens. And I ain't even chased this dream. I feel sorry for those who did. Y'all niggas can't stop the war. Whether rock or raw, I'm swinging coke in a rock for law. You niggas know it's block or more. Block and palm. You wanna get shot, karate chop, or stab this on. Nigga, the truth. Every time I step in the booth, I speak the truth. Y'all know what I'm bringing to you. I bring the truth. Motherfuckers know who I be. I be the truth. When I speak, self set you free. Nigga, the truth. Every time I step in the booth, I speak the truth. Y'all know what I'm bringing to you. I bring the truth. Motherfuckers know who I be. I be the truth. When I speak, self set you free. Nigga, Black Friday management and rocks the label. And I still hit you niggas with shots that's fatal. That bullshit best can't save you. I had a doctor open you up from chest to navel. See my face on cable and have flashbacks of that cold ass table and the holes I gave you. I'm that nigga that'll come and pour salt in your wound at the hospital while the cops guard in your room. You got to see what I've seen, look where I've looked, touch what I reached, detect what I took. You got to go where I've gone, walk where I walk to get where I'm at, to speak what I talk. You got to lay where I lay, stay where I stay, play where I play, to make what I make. You got to move what I move, use what I use, use tools how I use, use fools how I use. Nigga, the truth. Every time I step in the booth, I speak the truth. Y'all know what I'm bringing to you. I bring the truth. Motherfuckers know who I be. I be the truth. When I speak, self set you free. Nigga, the truth. Every time I step in the booth, I speak the truth. Y'all know what I'm bringing to you. I bring the truth. Motherfuckers know who I be. I be the truth. When I speak, self set you free. Nigga, the truth.
Listen. First and foremost, shout out Team Rob. Y'all already know what the fuck it is. Black first, second, and third. And I want y'all to understand something. This is going to be a black first, second, and third conversation. It's going to be a conversation for people who can actually critically think about this shit, as opposed to, you know, being tied up in knots about it, as opposed to being terrified about it, as opposed to acting like, as these church folks saying, we back in the last days yet again. We was just in the last days when children are being murdered by caves in schools. We was in the last days, and now it's doubling up. We in the last days again. So we're going to talk about all of that. If you this video in live is not going to be for the faint of heart. OK, it's not me. I'm not going to be on here fear mongering, telling y'all what to be scared of and all this other extra ass shit. I'm not going to be doing that. Some of y'all have saw the first live I did about this when this was just a conversation, because before this actually went to the Supreme Court and they did, you know, they did the vote and overturned it. It was a conversation about it first. They were, you know, they got caught talking about it or caught out here. And of course, people were talking about it then. I'm not going to reiterate that entire live I did, because everything I said in that live, if you go back and watch it, it is facts as to what's happening right now. So I'm not going to go rehash that entire live again. One thing I do want to make sure that everyone listening to this understands, and anybody who's going to have an opinion about this, the one thing you must know, the one thing you absolutely must know, is that what happened here was that now the states have the power to determine whether or not abortion is going to be a legal thing in the state. In other words, just like with marijuana. If you're just a slight bit confused, you look at how each state treats marijuana laws, whether it's, you know, for medical reasons over here and recreational over there, and it's all good over here. You can do whatever you want. It's the same situation. It's the exact same situations. The states now have the power to mandate whether or not you can get an abortion in their state. 13 states have an absolute ban on abortion. An absolute ban. And I don't got all the, I should have pulled the 13 states up in front of me, but it's mostly the ones in what they're calling the South. Most of them down there, right? And, you know, I'm seeing people have this conversation as if they done said that you, in every single state, you can't, you don't have the right to have an abortion. So I want people to make sure they understand that first and foremost. Okay. It's up to the state. So say in the state I live in, which is North Carolina, they have a rule as to how long. I think it's about 4 or 5 months. And if you ask me, if you ain't decided in 4 or 5 months, then something fucking wrong with you anyway. You see what I'm saying? So there may be something a little bit off if you want to go at 7.5 months to do this. All right. Do I believe that men should be telling women what to do with their body? Absolutely not. Okay. What you must understand, especially if you are black in this country, is that these cavemen have been, they're doing this because their birth rate is down. Now, we talked about this initially, and of course, when you talk about this, and this is not just me talking about this, you can go back to Dr. Francis Cress Welsing, who was trying to tell people how much they fear genetic annihilation. They fear it so much they're going to make their bitches have babies. Okay? That's how scared they are. So it ain't just, you know, what we're saying and what these so-called conscious or woke or whatever y'all want to call people, pro-black. Y'all want to deem everything as hotep conspiracy theories, like motherfuckers just be hotep dreaming out here. And we trying to tell you what the fuck these caves act like when they are faced, when they backs against the wall, so to speak. When they trapped between a cave and a hard place. We know how these people get down. They will even allow their own to be slaughtered, murdered. They don't care. Okay, you see that behavior as when they're talking about these so-called gun laws. They can have a whole school of their kids shut up. They will shrug. Okay, these are the people that y'all are trying to tap into the morality of, because somehow in your mind, you've been under this ideology that the caves are righteous, moral, they're humane. This is why y'all look up to them. This is why we exist in a space where we're always trying to prove to them that we're better. This is what happens. This is the idea that we have of these people. But if you look historically, this is the type of shit they do. For the longest, they wouldn't let their bitches vote. They don't fuck with their women like y'all will act like they do. They don't. The women that give birth to them, they don't fuck with them like that. Now, what I'm seeing happen is it's becoming a man-woman conversation. And black people, generally speaking, they're so damn dumb that they will turn it into a black man versus black woman situation. Because we're that dumb. No power in this country whatsoever. But we like to turn towards each other and act like, you know, well, you're the reason that this is happening. These are cavemen. The divestors will tell you that these cavemen care about their women. Matter of fact, they treat their women so great that that's where black women should run to. Even though we're watching these motherfuckers strip away rights, the right of a choice for women. That's the caves. That's how they conduct themselves. If you actually interested, you can go look at child marriage laws too. I know we don't really want to, people don't want to get into that, but you go look at what the cave's doing out here. And then at the same time, you have certain black people, and I would argue most black people worship these people, and you have these so-called divestors that are telling you this is the better group of men. What you also must understand is once they make it a state issue, they're going to be pushing more of this voting narrative. They're going to be pushing more of this voting narrative. And what that means is that they're acting like, just like this law got overturned, acting like, well, if this person gets in here, then abortion will be okay. Well, if somebody else come in here, then abortion won't be okay. They're going to be going back and forth with this shit. At least that's how they're making it seem. Because now what they want you to believe is that, well, now y'all black people, y'all see these Republicans over here running amok. So it's time for y'all to vote Democrat hard again. It's time for that. Right? They will make it seem as though, well, if black people just come out here and vote in the propensity, then maybe we can do something about this. Because black people are highly upset about this being overturned. Highly upset. So what they're doing is they're playing on your emotionalism like they always do, same way they did our women, black women back during this feminist movement. These cave bitches gonna come out here and act like they caring about you. And that works on y'all for some reason. This works on all of our people for some reason. They can act like they're caring about you. Black women, that is false. Do not let these sign-holding bitches make you believe that they care about you as a black woman. They need your numbers as to being a woman. Which, hell, we don't even know if it's clearly defined what a woman is anymore. They're trying to fuck with that, too. I do not want black women to fall for the trick that somehow these cave hoes caring about what happened to you at all. Because if it was just against you, then bitches would be at home. Know that. Understand that. If this was just about you, then bitches wouldn't be out there. But they're able to come and use your womanhood to strengthen their numbers and their problem with their men. That's what they've been doing. From voting to wages to sexual harassment to full-blown out rape. That's what they've been doing. And they're trying to pull on your heartstrings to talk about the would-be rape victims. Victims of molestation and rape. They'll highlight these situations where y'all going to force these women to have these children. No, cavemen are. Understand who's doing this. Because one of my main problems with this is I never see these motherfuckers called out by name. One of the reasons you may not see them called out by name because they got a face up here. Look what they did. Let me show y'all something. I'm going to share the screen for a second. And we're going to read through this article. This is one of the reasons. Because coon ass Clarence Thomas, his face is jumping. And his face is the one that's out here. his coon ass. Me and Goddess Ayana, maybe two weeks ago, we talked about Clarence Thomas, old coon ass, also overturning the right for an inmate to appeal his sentences or his sentence based on inadequate counsel. He just got rid of that too. They would throw his ass out there. And if they're not going to throw him, they're going to throw Trump out there. All of a sudden, Donald Trump, as they do, as they've been doing for a while now, all of a sudden, Donald Trump is the reason that the world or this nation is heading in this direction. I would argue it's because they will not deal with the pathology of the caveman and the bitches who give birth to him. They refuse to deal with their pathology. That was before Donald Trump showed up. These are the same people that have not been dealing with their pathology the entire time. They don't want to deal with it. They're going to pathologize black people and act like we're the issue. Meanwhile, they're going to sit here and take away the right for a woman to choose, forcing a woman to have a child she don't want to give birth to if you live in that state. Now, there are some states that are saying you can go across state lines. States like California say, hey, we're going to be a haven for women to come have an abortion out here. So if y'all got a problem, say in Washington State, you can drive your ass down to Cali and we'll take care of you. There are some states that are doing that. There are even some companies that are saying, hey, we'll pay for your travel expense if you have to travel far to get an abortion. We'll pay for that expense for you. Some companies are doing that to try to balance this shit out. Now, of course, you got Democrats out here losing their fucking mind, acting like this is just the most egregious thing that they've ever seen in their life. Like they don't know that the caves act like this. And this is how you know Democrats, I don't give a damn whether they're a cave, black, or whoever, Democrats are disingenuous. Because they know what the fuck white people get into. They know what the caves get into when their back's against the wall. But they're not talking about that. You're not going to hear any conversations about a Democrat coming out here saying, well, you know, these motherfucking caves just mad because they're at a minus birth rate. These cave bitches are not bringing life, the cave life into the world at the rate that's necessary to replenish the numbers. And because of that, that's why we're seeing this. They won't be honest like that. That's not politically correct. It's not politically correct to call out this cave pathology. That's a problem. And you may even get called racist yourself for talking about it. Some of us experienced that, right? Now, what you got to understand is I'm going to read through this article. Here you have coon-ass Clarence Thomas, whose cave hole wife is on trial for being involved in the Capitol riots. Because when white folk really care about something, that's the type of shit they get into, okay? His wife is dealing with that because she racist as fuck. And his coon ass racist too. I'm going to read the little caption here. It says, in future cases, we should reconsider all of this court's substantive due process precedents, including Griswold, Lawrence, and Obergefell. Now, let me show y'all what those involve, because I don't want us to get this confused, because those things are going to be the next thing that people are going to be crying about. Let me come down here and show y'all what that means, and then we're gonna get back into it. It said, in case those names sound unfamiliar to you, Griswold was a landmark 1965 case protecting the right to contraceptives, birth control, and I don't know whether that includes condoms or not, but at least birth control. He's trying to get that tossed up out of here too. Lawrence was a landmark 2003 case that ruled that criminal punishment for sodomy between consenting adults was unconstitutional. Okay? Sodomy. Now, that's going to be, most people are making that completely about homosexuals, but what this is saying is, even if you're a man and it's a woman, you can't be going in the ass. And if y'all don't understand, sodomy also involves head. And I done told y'all that. If you look it up, it involves oral too. Some of y'all might be a little affected by that. Now, I don't know how they would see what you're doing, but this also involves head. Do not believe you safe because you ain't into asshole fucking. Because I would argue if you are, you're probably a little bit gay anyway, right? But that's sodomy also includes oral. Now, again, I don't know why people never think about that, but it also includes oral as well. Criminal punishment for sodomy between consenting adults was unconstitutional. So he's saying people should be punished for sodomy because he ain't getting no head. They mad about that. I probably mad about that. And Obergefell was the landmark 2015 case that guaranteed same-sex couples the right to marry. So now what I'm seeing is the homosexual community, they're up in arms because their right to be married is also something that's up on the chopping block. Okay, this is what I was, so we got birth control, anal sex and head, even though head is silent typically when talking about sodomy, and homosexual marriage. Now, here's my thing. As Clarence Thomas and his minions go about doing this, as they do this, here's my thing. Understand this. And I said this to someone, they actually got mad at me. Because somebody asked me what I thought about this. And I said, well, hopefully it'll get worse. And when I said that, they got mad at me because they didn't understand what I meant by, well, hopefully it'll get worse. So here you have food shortages, gas prices. They're coming for abortion rights, which are essentially women's rights who give birth to everybody on the fucking planet. They're also, we got gas prices high. We got them. They still not want to pay people a workable wage. I want it to get worse because it is in my belief that the only way people going to stand up and actually see and stand up and actually fight is if everything does get worse. At least even if you just perceive it to be worse, that's the only thing that's going to charge people into action. So I shrugged. Again, this doesn't mean I don't care about women's rights. It means that I understand that people are going to be holding up these signs, talking about their wombs, you know, talking all this shit. But then what they're going to do is run their ass back to clock in that next morning. And that's the problem. This is why marching, protesting, standing in the streets, holding your motherfucking sign, talking about your womb, talking about men being forced to have vasectomies. You can hold all the signs you want. But as long as you're taking your ass back to work, you wasting your motherfucking time. Those are facts. I mean, theoretical facts, but I believe that. As long as you still clocking in, you can cry about the gas all day. As long as you still gonna get your ass up Monday morning, be to work on time, no one gives a fuck what you're talking about. The price of gas, wages not being right, and this same situation as well. With women's rights and what the right for them to choose what happens with their body. The only way people gonna be able to see this shit is if it gets worse. If they come for contraceptives, homosexual marriage, you know, these LGBTQs, they're not about to sit on their ass. No, they're not gonna do it. They're gonna be up running around here taking problems to people's front door. They're gonna be doing that. Everybody's gonna be moving that way. But the one way we refuse to move is to sit your ass down somewhere. This entire economy is based on you taking your ass to work. I've said this, I've been saying this for years, and it's just another situation where I'm going to be reiterating something I've already said. That's the reason I'm not mad about this. I've been mad. So, and I'm not saying that you should be a martyr. I'm not saying that, you know, you, this one person who has this idea, can just quit your job. It won't have the impact. It won't have the effect because you're just one person. These states that are banning abortion completely, if that state really has a problem, if the population really has a problem, because what we have to be real about is in most of these states, the people who are there, the majority of people that's there, they don't have a problem with this. Y'all, they're not mad about it. I'm seeing people be mad in states that it don't even, it's like, You ain't even over there. The people who live in, say, a state like Texas, Mississippi, if the entire state, or at least the majority of the state of Mississippi or Texas, if they mad enough about it, all they got to do is stay at home. You don't got to die. You ain't got to shoot no guns. You don't have to hold any signs. All you have to do is organize people enough to sit their ass down. Stay at home. Stop working. Once they see you that serious, they're not going to come at you telling you what you can do with your body, man. Women outnumber men in this country. If women are really mad, stop going to work. Stop going to work. That's what it's going to take, y'all. Nobody wants to hear that because it's so scary to people to think about what can happen to you if you don't go to work. And they honestly, it's almost like, you know how in the Bible they created hell? People think if they don't go to work, it's the equivalent to that fear that they have of hell. They think the worst thing is going to happen, not knowing, because you've never did it. You've never tried it. This is not a method that we've even ever used. You don't even know what's going to happen, but you're just scared. They're going to kick me out of my house. They're going to turn all my shit off. They're not going to treat a majority of a state like that, period. They can't. Because if everybody ain't going to work, who the hell coming to turn your lights off? Who coming? Who coming to turn them off if ain't nobody going to work? And the men, also, so this is just take the entire population of men, or of women, rather, who outnumber men in this country. Take the entire population of women and take the men who actually stand with and support women. That's the majority of the nation. That's the majority of the nation right there, because you already got majority with just women by themselves. What you mean? Why are you holding the sign? They don't care about that, which is why they were able to make this move in front of everybody's face. And I keep trying to tell y'all this, and people keep acting like I'm crazy. And black men and women, it's not the time for you to be arguing amongst yourself. Black man, you don't make no laws. If you beating your chest about this, if you're bragging about it because you like to see negative things happen to women, or to black women in particular, something's fucking wrong with you. You a fucking coon. That's a coon's mentality. You beating your fucking chest just because something negative happened to black women. Meanwhile, you get your ass gunned down by the fucking cops, 3Ks, but then you expect support from black women. But you happy about anything negative that's going on that will affect black women's right to choose. You a bitch ass nigga. You a hoe ass nigga. You a coon ass nigga. And you make us all look bad because you motherfuckers be the loudest. You motherfuckers be the most vocal, and you motherfuckers get the most attention. There is no winning if either one of us is oppressed in any type of way whatsoever. There's no one up for a black man being gunned down by the cops. There's no one up for black women being told that they don't get to choose what happens to their child. This country wants to force you to have a child. Force you to have a child. Because not only does the white population need their numbers to maintain or be high, it's not what y'all think it's about, though. They need workers. They want the working class people. They want majority of the working class people to be the caves. It's their country, right? They're going to want most of the working class to be them. That's how they want to run this. They want to stay with their numbers in the majority so they make up most of the working class. To make up most of the working class is power. They're losing that power. They need these working people. They need these bodies created so they can send them little caves to fuel the workforce. So that board of directors, that whole board of directors, caves. The upper management, caves. Y'all know this. They mad about the fact that they about to have a problem with controlling the workforce. They about to have a very serious problem controlling the workforce. Because, I mean, they've been a minority on the planet. I mean, they know that. It's their numbers they're using. And, you know, they sent out that silent alarm that said that, well, we Our numbers are getting low. Their numbers been low. But they need all those CEOs, the manager, the supervisor, the upper working class. They just want their workers. They want to keep the majority on the workforce. Because you know they don't give a fuck about their lives. I mean, again, they let their kids get gunned down. They don't give a fuck about none of that shit. Shoving these shots into them, they don't give a fuck. Now, black people, it's going to affect you more. Of course, everything always affects us more, right? In these states where they're banning abortion, is going to affect you more because now they're forcing you to have a child, even though your mortality rate in the hospital, and this is supposed to be a safe space, or at least it's perceived to be such, you're dying at a 700% rate higher than any other race of woman giving birth. That's in a safe space. That's not including how creative. I'm not just saying that black women will be creative, but these cave holes have always been creative about how they're going to kill their kids. They will shove a clothes hanger up in that cave, disgusting pussy, and pull it out. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They're going to find a way. You're not going to stop. People are going to find ways, whether it's safe, sanitary, it doesn't matter. People are going to find ways. And what's so crazy about a lot of these cave motherfuckers, they actually believe forcing or taking away the abortion is supposed to boost their numbers when they have to look at the trash womb of the cave hole. Don't nobody want to talk about that either. This bitch is struggling. The caveman, his sperm is weak. Struggling. It's motherfuckers that will try to get pregnant for years and cannot. They cannot. How the fuck they gonna fix that? Now, of course, we're seeing what they're doing with this technology. As far as these artificial wombs and things like this, all this is showing you that these caves are inferior to you. Actually, so-called white supremacy is really about their inferiority. So they're going to try everything. This right now, they're just trying it with laws. They'll poison your food, poison your water. Right now, they're just doing it with laws. And they're thinking that, well, these states will force women to have children. This will help us. It won't. That's why I don't know why y'all ain't. We shouldn't really be worried. Now, one thing that black people do need to take from this, you better be smarter about. You must be smarter about the situation you're putting yourself in to either A, get pregnant by somebody, or B, get somebody pregnant. You got to be smarter about it. And again, I'm not going to keep letting people take this and make it about rape victims. I don't understand why rape victims aren't given a plan B upon the rape. I don't even get that. I don't get it. Upon the rape, they should be given plan B pills, which are, if y'all are now, I know they be doing this crypto and all this little shit, and they may be coming for contraceptives, but plan Bs and all this type of stuff is going to boom. I know rich motherfuckers probably investing in stock in this shit. But I don't want this conversation to be about rape and incest, because that's such a small percentage of the people who go actually have abortions. Small percentage of people doing that for those reasons. Okay? Small percentage of people having abortions because the mom is going to die upon giving birth. I don't want to say this word wrong. It's either apoptic or epoptic pregnancy, and y'all correct me if I'm wrong, that it's going to kill the mom if she gives birth. That's not what makes up most of abortions. The caves know that, and they're trying to control their women. It's just that all women are going to get swept up, but really what they're trying to control is their women having and giving birth to them. That's what they're trying to control. That's what they're trying to control. Now, is that going to work? I don't think so. Because one thing I know about these cave women is they're going to be creative. They want to kill some shit, they're going to kill some shit. They're going to find ways to do whatever the fuck they want to do. They're going to do that. Now, they're going to swoop in black women. They're going to swoop in all these other groups of women and make it everybody's issue. But it's really, this is a war and a fight between the caveman and the cavewoman, like always. They just mask it really well. They say men, women, when it's really white men, white women. That's what it really is. But they mask it well. They'll make it a nation's. It's all of our issues. No, that's your birth rate. And I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to show y'all this. I'm going to show y'all, this is why I know. Somebody said ectopic. I'm still saying it wrong. Ectopic or tubal pregnancy. To fix me possibly fucking it up earlier. Thank you for that. Let me show y'all this. Black folk thought they had, see, they thought they had damn, they thought they actually seen something when they start talking about this. Watch this. Watch this, Kavo. Watch this. Y'all listen. I'm gonna share this really quickly because this is why I know black people be confused. Watch this. Listen to this, Kavo. I hate they won't just turn the sound on, goddamn.
On behalf of all the MAGA patriots in America, I want to thank you for the historic victory for white life in the Supreme Court yesterday.
Y'all heard it?
President Trump, on behalf of all the MAGA
white life,
patriots
listen.
In America, I want to thank you for the historic victory for white life in the Supreme Court yesterday.
Now, listen, black folks saw this and said, did y'all hear her? And my question is, what if y'all been listening to all these years? They've been saying that. They've been. Like, what? You can just go look up. I mean, if you want to start with Margaret Sanger, like, they haven't been hiding the fact that their goal and mission is to preserve the white race. That's been their goal and mission. Being, that ain't new. That wasn't nothing that should be surprising because black people are the ones that sit out here don't give a fuck about preserving their race. These coon ass niggas that believe they can fuck all the cave holes in the world and then somehow take over racism. These type of motherfuckers. It's you that don't care. The caves been caring. And no pun intended because I know y'all call them Karens. They been caring about preserving their race. They've been thinking about this shit. They put scientists to work on this shit. Black folk the ones out here playing around. Now, of course, we don't have to be as serious because clearly we just give birth and, you know, our birth rate gonna remain high because motherfuckers pull out game is trash. And the way that we have children isn't as planned and organized as other groups of people try to make it seemed like their shit is playing organized, if I can say it that way. Because it's fake. It's not real. You know, this idea that when a white man lays with a beautiful cave bitch and they have a kid, they just raise this kid together and life goes on happily ever after. Well, that's a lie. That ain't how it really happens. That's the propaganda that they use against you to make you feel like shit. And it works because your self-esteem shows that it's been working all these years. They don't have their shit together. This is why they're at this point now. Look at what they have to do to look at the lengths they have to go through to try to control the women who give birth to them. Because they can't go in there and just say, well, just white bitches. It's really just white bitches. They can't write that into law. Then they have to, that's why they do the blanket statement, well, women, and this is all, you know, no woman can come have an abortion in this state. They don't really want to do all that. But they worried about the caves. That's who they worried about. And they've been worried about themselves. Black folk, y'all don't care. Y'all out here playing games. These caves don't play. They'll use fucking our bodies and health against us. They'll use laws. And they'll circumvent those laws. It don't, if it'll fit them. Because this is a law that was overturned. Understand, that means that laws don't really mean much if somebody can then come around and then overturn it. All they need is a majority vote or whatever as they play these types of games. Well, it could just be overturned. So then what the fuck is a law? The laws are built and made to protect whiteness. Nobody was mad about that, though. Y'all should have been mad about that 10 years, 15 years, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Laws are built and made to protect whiteness. Now, white folk ain't had no problem with that. The caves have been okay with that. It's only at times like this where then they will act like, well, they appalled. I can't believe that these cavemen are like, why the fuck can't you believe it, cave ho? Why can't you believe it? And any black woman or man that's talking about this, if you can't believe it, why can't you believe it? What the fuck do the caves be doing to make y'all believe or have this faith in them? I don't understand it. What the fuck are they? I don't look at them like y'all do. So maybe somebody can help me in the comments or in the feed. But what the fuck do they be doing to where y'all can't believe the shit that they do? The laws that they write, that they break all the time to oppress you anyway. Why can't you believe them? Why does anything that they do shock you? And you're appalled by it. These cave hoes know who they're giving birth to. They know who don't want to pay them their a working wage, the same as me. And they know who doing that. They know who told them they couldn't fucking vote. But they want to act like it's all men oppressing them that way. No, bitch, it's your son. And that's what we need to start saying to these motherfuckers. No, bitch, that's your son. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's your son acting like that. You raised him to act like that. You raised him to behave this way. And you can't stop him. So now you're going to bring your ass out here with our people holding signs and shit? That's what you're going to do? But no matter what, these cave hoes will line. Well, they'll be in line. As long as it's not affecting them directly or specifically, these bitches will stand in line with these cavemen. It's not until the caveman is infringing upon her that she will act like she one human being with all people. Bitch, stop lying. But we don't want to talk to the cave hoes like that, right? We don't want to call them out for what they are for real. As you saw that video I just played, there's Donald Trump and some cave ho, and in the background, there are people that are clapping for this. Sheep that are happy, hiding under the guise of Christianity. That's what they hide. They hiding under that. They will sit here and act like this is about God and Christ. And then they'll turn around and talk about separation of church and state. What you have to understand about these caves, like I just said, they will manipulate the laws to fit their agendas. Separation of church and state, but then talk about God as it pertains to abortions. They're going to hide behind that guise of Christianity. Because, I mean, technically, they're not wrong. Y'all not supposed to be out here killing y'all kids. That's murder, right? Y'all not supposed to be doing it. And we understand that Christians nip and then they pick and they build anything they want to do out of this Bible, right? We understand that Christians operate this way. They're hypocrites, a lot of them, right? But on a country that says in God we trust, it's built on so-called Christian values. They're only Christian when it comes to them pushing forward their agenda. They're not Christian when it comes to loving all humans the same, because then we'd be sitting out here working on feeding the homeless, making sure that everybody has health care, making sure that all people have clean drinking water. If it was really about some God in the fucking Bible, but it's not. Has nothing to do with that. Y'all have made them the moral authority. Y'all allowed them to use the Bible to make you feel like you ain't shit. If it was really about that, you wouldn't see a lot of these problems that you're seeing out here right now. Well, children are dying because they have inadequate health care. How the fuck you said God? Did you say something about God? The Bible? I got to put my hand on this book before I even testify in this corrupt ass system. So they use that Bible to hide their fucked upness, especially here in what they would deem the Bible Belt in the South. They'll use that Bible then, but then they'll say, fuck that Bible when it comes to protecting human life. Then they get to use it again to force these cave hoes to have their kids. It's not going to work like that. It's not going to work like that. I'm going to tell you how I know. Like I said at the beginning of this video, you can compare it to, as the states are being able to decide, you can compare it to weed, marijuana, right? As each state has its own ideology as it pertains to the criminality of marijuana. Don't people still smoke in every state? Right? Maybe not you, but just because something is illegal, it ain't stop nobody from getting high. It's not going to stop it. Most states, by the time they legalize marijuana, they say something about legalizing marijuana. The motherfuckers that was smoking just say, well, now I can smoke out in public. I was doing this shit anyway. People going to find a way. Now, of course, you're going to have, we got to go through this first burst of emotionalism where women going to be standing in the streets, holding signs, still going to work, though. I'm telling y'all, if y'all want this shit to stop, stop going to work. Very simple. I ain't even got to use a whole lot to say that. Sit your ass down somewhere. Don't go to work. But people are going to do whatever the fuck they're going to do, period. This is just them making a so-called law. We know who the law is going to be enforced more strictly upon because this is targeting cave bitches. It's targeting the caves mainly. So the law is going to be imposed on them the hardest. Okay. I honestly feel like this is one of the times where they're not really even, they focusing on cave hoes. They're trying to oppress their own women. And they do a good job of that. And until they women call them out for this, I think it's going to continue. Because they're continuing to act like this is all men in the nation trying to tell them that they can't, they don't have a right to be pro-choice. The pro-lifers have been using the Bible to justify them yelling and screaming and holding signs for the longest. They've been justifying their behavior, their erratic, ridiculous behavior, by using the Bible. Black folk notice that the Bible is used against you all the time. Even though you still allow yourself to worship this book, worship the man who wrote it, worship the characters that are within this book. That book is always used against you. Always. And pro-lifers use that book to justify why they should yell at somebody, a woman, who's possibly going to make one of the most difficult decisions she's ever made in her life. Now, I'm not going to sit here and act like every woman, it's a difficult decision. Like, I've known some women in my life that it wasn't that difficult of a decision. They was on their way. It wasn't nothing they cried about. Wasn't that big deal to them. They didn't have 3-4 of them motherfuckers. It wasn't nothing they lost no sleep over. Right? But them motherfuckers holding them stupid ass signs, screaming, yelling, quoting Bible verses, they've been doing that. Been doing it. This is not something I want black people to pick up. Black women, do not put these white hoes on your shoulders. Don't do it. I'm telling you, they're not worthy to be even next to you, first of all. But they damn sure don't deserve to be on your fucking shoulders. Don't allow them to get up there. Do not hoist these bitches up. I know you've done it before. You've done it before. You let these bitches get on your fucking shoulders. And they use you to be a mouthpiece for them. No. Our people, what we're going to do to combat this is practice discipline. Planning. And actually having conversations with motherfuckers. In these states, y'all going to the club, meeting a nigga, fucking him full blown, you know, like don't know who he is. That's dead. We don't do that no more. No, we don't do that. I don't care how fine he is. We don't do that no more. Our women don't do that. And that's not something that's difficult. Just don't do that. We got to be more disciplined. This shit can't touch us. Our birth rate is not what the issue is. And that's with all of the abortions that we have amongst us as a people. Our birth rate ain't the problem. They're the ones that are scared. We just got to be disciplined. That's all. And you can, if you want to travel across state lines, that's fine too. Understand this is about the states. But we just got to be more disciplined. That's all this is. We got to be more disciplined because what they're trying to do is force you to have a child. And once they force, once you have that child, they don't give a fuck about that child. Not even their own. So that, to me, that's the blatant hypocrisy of it. They don't give a fuck about no child being born. Or the child would have free health care. Checkups would be free. There would be no issues. Children wouldn't be malnourished, hungry, sick, when the sicknesses can be cured with antibiotics. They don't give a fuck about these kids once they're born. And that's been proven. They don't give a fuck. They're not making sure these kids are fed. Look at foster homes. All these kids in foster homes and shit. It's already a problem. It's already an issue. They don't care nothing about no fucking kids for real. Do not let them make you believe that they do. I don't give a fuck what they say about pro-life. They worried about numbers. That's how simple they are. They're able to be diabolical based on simple numbers. To me, the numbers of people that they have within the workforce. That's what I believe it's coming down to. But they don't give a fuck about no kids. Not for real. Y'all remember how many times they done had an issue where children getting free lunches at school? How many times that's been an issue? They don't care nothing about no kids. They don't. Not in reality. They do not care anything about children. And you, these caves going to be on here talking about, well, like this white bitch said, well, victory for white life. They don't even give a fuck about their own kids. Because I'm going to tell you the people they leave out. We talk about them sometimes over here, the trailer parks, where the meth labs is. The trailer parks. They don't give a fuck about them kids. This is why you'll have some of these caves that come out here and they try to relate to you as far as being broke is concerned. Well, they'll think that they just like you because they didn't have food either. Because they struggled too. That's why they think they can relate to you. Because a lot of them motherfuckers are actually poor as fuck. They don't even give a fuck about their own kids. They don't care about the health of children, the safety. Look at what the fuck they do every time a school shut up. They double security at the cave schools? No. They send all the security to black schools where we don't have mass shootings. They trying to find all the weed. They looking for all the weed. The caves come to shoot the schools up, but they won't put more security at the schools. They don't give a fuck about their kids for real. And don't let them make you think that they do. It ain't real. It's not real shit. But I don't want people to panic. See, that's my thing. I'm seeing a whole lot of fear mongering. And I hate fear mongering. Y'all know if y'all watch me, I hate fear mongering. What they gonna do next? Only what you allow them to. Last days, they only do what we allow them to do. If you live in a state, and most of that state is mad about this, stop going to work. Watch what happened. Watch what happened. Sit out. Watch what happened. I was sitting here, I was talking to a woman here in North Carolina. She mad, and it don't even affect her. Like, we have to understand, like, this is not really affecting you specifically that way. And I understand you having commentary about it, but why are you being this mad? It's the caves doing what they've been doing. Why ain't you been mad? I don't like new mad motherfuckers. I hate it. And that's why I said I don't mind if this shit get worse. If they come for contraceptive, if they come for sodomy, if they come for gay marriage, I'm hoping they come for enough that will make the working class people sit their ass down somewhere and you win. That's how you win. You ain't got to go through all this yelling and shit. You don't got to do that. And it can't come down to the vote. Especially where black people are concerned. Like, we don't make a majority population in no state. This is about these cave hoes. And a lot of these cave hoes is mad. But do not allow them to make you believe they understand you now because of this. Because these motherfuckers will run around here and compare everything to slavery. Y'all notice how they do that? They want to compare everything to slavery. That's how insensitive they are about what your people have went through in this country at the hands of their people. It shows their insensitivity. This ain't got shit to do with no damn slavery. It's nothing like slavery. The tools and equipment that they used during these abortions was first experimented. Our women were used, black women were used on plantations, no anesthesia, no anything. That type of vile, nefarious, diabolical, fucked up ways. That's what they did. They practiced and used experiments on our people. So ain't nothing like slavery. Because you couldn't just sit down and not work doing slavery, you stupid bitch. All you got to do now is sit your stupid ass down. That wasn't an option. You sit down, you end up dying. That's what slavery was. You don't get to compare what you're going through because you're too fucking cowardly to stand up for yourself. You don't get to compare anything to slavery. And y'all need to stop allowing them to do that shit and still respecting these people and like they're real people. These motherfuckers are fucked up and they're insensitive towards you and you let them be. And you wake up to worship them every day. All these bitches got to do is sit their asses down. That's no comparison to slavery at all. They said the same thing about wearing them stupid ass masks. It's like slavery. No, the fuck is not. Because don't nobody come up and beat the shit out of you for taking it off. Not the same. Nowhere near the same. But y'all let them say it. I feel where they coming from. Black women, stop. Stop feeling where they coming from. Because they don't never feel where you coming from. Why the fuck are black people always reaching back to feel where the cave is coming from? I mean, they don't never feel you. But they keep bringing up slavery, acting like this shit is the same. When all they gotta do is sit at home. If they wanna change the world, shock the nation, sit your ass down somewhere. You wanna change the gas prices, sit your ass down somewhere. They ain't nothing like slavery. And y'all need to stop letting them say that type of shit. If you are in the B123 mindset, if I'm making any sense here, y'all, put a B123 in the chat, and I'm going to actually get to some of y'all's comments because I haven't been looking at the comments because I wanted to keep my thoughts straight about this. Because, again, it's just me reiterating what I've been saying, what I said the first time I talked about this. But if I'm making sense to you, put a B123 in the chat. Y'all hit that like button for me because, again, I don't like scared motherfuckers, man. I don't know. It's something about scary motherfuckers, man. Black folk always carrying everything for everybody. Stop it. Our people, stop it. This is a fight between the caveman and the cavewoman. Let them kill each other. Like, what? They can go at each other's necks all day, all night. Who cares? They're going to turn into a Democrat-Republican thing. They're going to be sitting around. I see Maxine Waters, old coon ass, talking about she gonna fight against it. No, you're not, because you would have been telling women, just sit your ass down, don't go to work. If you're really serious about, you know, really causing change, then you're telling people don't go to work. You're not talking about voting. You're not talking about holding no signs. You're not talking about doing none of that. You're telling the majority population in this nation that brings all life to existence to stay your ass home from work. That's what you're doing. Come on, we're going to defy this. Bitch, you're not going to defy anything. You ain't defied shit. A Democrat doesn't defy anything. And you know how black women, I love me some Auntie Maxine. For what? She gets on TV and don't represent you and lies to you. She don't talk hard enough. No, none of these Democrats talk hard enough. These motherfuckers be talking about some damn bipartisanship. Well, we need them so we can do something. Get on TV and tell the truth. If the working class people ever look in the mirror and realize the power that we have, that the people have, they could change the whole fucking world overnight. That's the truth. And you don't hear no politician saying it. So all of them ain't worth a fuck if you ask me. What you gonna do, Maxine? How you gonna defy them? Just talking. Saying any goddamn thing. You don't live in Mississippi. You don't live in Texas. Can't do shit. But that's what the Democrats do. They're going to turn this into, well, y'all see these Republicans and they be taking these rights, so just get the Democrats in here. No. It's by time we look at this whole entire system, the whole political charade, and say we're done. We quit. We out. Because clearly nothing's coming from that. At all. See, we talked about this. This is a good comment, Paris. Paris says, Rob, I really wish I could stop going to work. Send a message, but I don't want to be the only one at home without money. I'm pregnant and two under three. I'd do it if I knew I wasn't the only one. That's what we talked about that earlier. I don't think you should be a martyr. This is, again, look, I would, if it was about that, I would do it. But I know it would just be me. Because people scared. What we got to understand, this is, I understand, I don't think you should. This is me having a conversation, talking to people who ain't ready. So I'm not, you shouldn't do this. I'm saying when you look at TV and you see all these motherfuckers standing in the streets holding their signs, they're going to work tomorrow. And that's the problem. It don't matter if you're holding that sign. I don't think you should be a martyr and you being the only one that's broken out in the street while the rest of everybody else still continuing to go to work. No, this will be a nationwide movement. Or in states where they're, you know, where people acting like they're mad, like say Mississippi, like say Texas, I think Tennessee as well. You know, I don't know every state, but if the people are really mad, they could use this method. But the fact of the matter is, nobody uses this method. And I don't think you should just throw yourself out there. No, I don't suggest that anybody does that. But if people really want change, you have to understand. If we're talking about change, because black people want change through capitalism mainly. Securing bags is supposed to be the change that we need in this world, right? If we really want to change anything, people going to have to sit their ass down and stop working. That's what it's going to take. Nobody wants to do it. We have all these other types of conversations. I understand the need to provide for your family. We are all out here, and wage slave is a real thing. And we talk about that concept here often on this channel, a wage slave. If you listen to what black people are scared of, because I talk to black people all the time, the main thing black folks scared of is losing their job. It terrifies them. And that's not just black people. Even the caves are terrified of losing their job. I want to be able to get paid and pay bills. If I don't do that, if I can't do that, the inability to be able to do that terrifies me. That's what people will tell you straight up and down, because of children. I got children to take care of. And this government knows that. That fear is there. So they run around here doing all this ridiculous ass shit. They know people can cry from the time they get off work Friday. They cry all day Sunday. They're gonna pray on their knees. Saturday they're gonna cry all day, pray on Sunday morning, get their asses up from praying, and take their ass back to work come Monday. They know that's the cycle. No matter how mad we get, no matter what the issue is, they know that people will not take the chance. They won't take the chance to lose that job and not be able to pay. That's why it has to be a movement. It can't be you doing it by yourself. You can't. You have to have a movement. This ain't double talk. Ronald, this ain't. Ronald says stop capping and tell her she needs to quit her damn job. You sound like a fucking idiot, bro. Be honest with you. I don't know whether you're black or white, but I'm not double talking. This ain't no double talk. This don't work if one or two people quit their job. You don't. That's not something that anybody's going to feel. I say working class people, not working class person, motherfucker, if you're paying attention. I didn't say working class person. I said working class people. People have to look around each other. While they at these rallies and boycotts, they got to look around and be like, God damn, we got to come up with something else. Maybe tomorrow we don't go to work. Because we're seeing it happen. We saw it happen. Let me see. Let me show this. I get some of y'all motherfuckers. It's like I'm talking and I'm trying to make it plain, but it's not plain enough. Like, I mean, what do you not understand? Let me show you what I'm talking about here. Where did I put this? I shared this. Here it is right here. Now these motherfuckers crazy. Here it is right here. What does that say? What does that say? Black, white, so-called Hispanic, 1,000 pilots. 1,000 pilots walked out protesting. I'll read it for you. Southwest Airlines says it respects the right of employees to freely express their opinions, and the airline doesn't expect any disruption to upcoming flights as a result of the union protest. Southwest declined to comment on the nature of the union's concerns. These pilots said they're not getting enough money. So what they're going to do is all the pilots, or at least majority of the pilots, no, we're going to stand down. Not only are we going to not, because again, look, they're holding signs. But they're not working. They're not working. If one pilot would have did that, it wouldn't be a story. It wouldn't be on Now This News. It wouldn't be getting attention. If one pilot does it by themselves, 2 pilots, 1,000 pilots, that's how you make a splash. That's how you make a splash. 1,000 pilots said, "Nah, I ain't flying shit. I'm sitting here landing these motherfucking planes, and I ain't making the money I should be making." Same thing as when teachers are complaining about their wages they make. I believe the teachers don't make enough. When the whole school district walk out, that's when you get their motherfucking attention. That's what it take. And I don't know how we see these things happen. We see these things happen. We see these types of movements, and we don't think nothing of it. Like, that's how you get these motherfuckers' attention. If teachers really mad about their pay, all they gotta do is have a national fucking boycott. All the teachers sit down. Bet you there'd be somebody knocking at their motherfucking door, like, okay, what can we do to get y'all back in here? Because I'd be damn if I sit in that classroom with these goddamn kids. I'd be damn if I do it. So what I gotta do to get you back in here? I'm not about to fly no motherfucking plane. I can't land it. I'll kill everybody in that bitch. What can I do to get you back in here? That's the power that unions even had, because they gotten rid of a lot of unions. But the unionizing workers, that's the type of shit it was about. Like, no, we're going to all sit down, motherfucker. We can't get this money. You don't want to pay us? Or we're going to all sit down then. And that's from the top line, like pilots here, down to janitors. If all the janitors quit, guess what? Motherfuckers going to be coming to janitors like, hey, you know, what, you know, I was talking shit about you because, you know, I didn't want to clean them. You're cleaning toilets and you mopping floors and shit. I was talking big shit, but I don't want to come do it. So what do I need to do to get you back in here? Pay them people. Right? Because a lot of people complaining about wages. Look at these gas prices, inflation, blah, blah, blah. Stop working. Watch everything change. when we stop believing that we have to work to exist. Same thing in this situation, no different. I just don't want black people panicking. And I want y'all Christians to shut the fuck up talking about the last days. You just got to stop. Stop panicking. Be more disciplined. Talk to your children. I know y'all hate that part. Oh boy, that bothers people. Talk to your children. Educate your children about what's going on out here. Your daughters and your sons. Educate them as to what's going on. Let them know what's going on out here. Now, I know y'all hate that. Y'all can't stand talking to y'all kids about nothing but Jesus. But black people, you're going to have to talk to your child about more than Jesus Christ, their Lord and Savior that's coming back, right? Because then are you going to raise his children that's talking about how we in the last days? And I got to listen to these motherfuckers talking. Quite frankly, I'm tired. Ain't we tired? I'm tired of listening to Christians. I don't know about y'all. I'm tired. I'm tired. You have to talk to your children. That's how we change this situation. That's how we give that knowledge. Teach your kids. And if they see you have heart and they see you have power, it's going to trickle down onto them anyway. But I would not advise parents. And y'all let me know. I'm looking at the comments now. So, right. Mystic. Mystic said they've been talking about the last days for the last 2,000 years. Right. Ever since the bitch ass nigga walked on water, so-called, they've been talking about when the last days. It's like, goddamn. Like, come on now. You not getting nobody nowhere, and that's all you got to say to your kids. Mom, dad, you know, what's going on out here? What's the implications of this new law? Well, you know, this the last days, and so go in there and pray. It's like, what the fuck? You didn't teach me anything. You didn't tell me nothing. Well, if you turn to Ecclesiastes 2:7, like, what the fuck? That ain't. It's not given. I think the young folks say shit like that, right? It's not given. Okay? It's not. Educate your children about more than Jesus, because y'all can teach them about Jesus all day. Guess what? These states, the so-called Bible Belt, these southern states, they're the ones that are saying, nah, fuck that. They saying, fuck that. And they're using that Bible to justify it. Same way they did with slavery. Y'all remember that? They justify that with the Bible. And black folk, y'all still teaching y'all kids this book. They use that book to justify everything. Fuck that. Fuck that. Fuck that book. We have to stand up for ourselves out here. When you see these political pundits on TV talking about Roe v. Wade and how they done set us back 50 years, that's what I keep saying. I even seen y'all's forever president, Barack, bitch ass Obama. I seen y'all's forever president talking about that done set us back 50 years. When it's the same bitch ass motherfucker that went up there to Flint, Michigan and drunk that water and said it's okay. Same lying motherfucker. Drone strike after drone strike all overseas. This is the same lying motherfucker talking about set us back 50 years. 50 years ago, it was about 1972. This is before the so-called crack era. What the fuck you mean set us back 50 years? Motherfuckers be acting like there's been some great progress made as it pertains to the legal system here in this country. And that's why I say America great. When? When was this? Set us back 50 years. That ain't got shit to do. That was 1972, bitch ass nigga. And what black people did when he said this is they just stood up and clapped. Like, this set us back 50 years. Where is this progress? What? I don't get the fact. I'm going to tell y'all what I believe. I think they do it to where if the year changes, that means there's progress. That's what it means. Because to set us back 50 years, it's like this, we ain't been forward nowhere. What the fuck are you niggas talking about? What are you saying? Set us back 50 years. That was 1972. Before they put crack in the neighborhoods. Before Reaganomics. What are you talking about? We've been back. As it pertains to this system, as it pertains to laws, as it pertains to the idea of so-called justice, what the fuck do they even be talking about? Wait, what'd you say? Obviously, his wife, by the way, went on late night TV to do jumping jacks instead of helping people in Flint. She has a Netflix show with Muppets that helps no one. Muppets. Yeah, listen. I've been in on Michelle Obama. I don't respect politicians, first of all. So I guess I have to say that first. Politicians, their husbands, their wives. I don't respect any of these motherfuckers. I don't respect them at all. I don't, because they lie. And even when they get would be out of office, or they're, you know, cause you know how the excuse that motherfuckers will give? Well, they in office, so they can't just be saying all of that. You know how motherfuckers are. Make excuses for these motherfuckers. They can't say all. They got a rip. Okay, well, even after they get out of office, they still coming in. Like, what? Now what? They still can't tell the truth. Now what? They still got to lie, downplay, tell you to go vote. Like, this is, what's the excuse now? I don't like that shit. I don't fuck with that. I didn't read it. I haven't read Michelle Obama's statement. But I've read some women's statements, and they all sound about the same. Her being a Democrat, she will make it about, you know, voting, the system, look what they're doing to women, you know, blah, blah, blah. But she won't call out who it is. She'll say Republicans, but she won't say the caves. And that's why I know the bitch is disingenuous. That's how I know they're disingenuous. Yeah, I did. I covered that. I covered the victory for white life. Because I'm going to tell you what, man. One thing about these cave hoes is they going to support they men. They're not going nowhere. Y'all know how y'all was playing that black woman clip where she was like, I'm going to stick beside him. That's the cave hoe. She's not going to turn her back on white men, which is why she don't call them out by name. That's why she say men. That's why she say men. And if you listen to the white man talk about women, he going to say women. He's not going to just say white women. Generally speaking, he's not going to do that. Black folk got this problem where we single each other out. Black men, blah, 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 blah. Black women, blah, blah, blah. White folk don't do that. The caves don't do that. They're going to stay on code. White life is a victory for all of them. I mean, that's just them staying on code. It is what it is. I can't then look at them staying on code, trying to preserve their so-called life, as minuscule and trash as it is. I can't look at them and then be like, well, that's fucked up. I don't think it's fucked up. That's why I'm not stressed. Gas prices go up, shrug. This shit right here happened, shrugs. Because people aren't mad enough yet. I don't know what it's going to take. I don't know what it's going to take. Because you know what's going to be happening tomorrow? You know what black men and women going to be doing? Talking about relationships. Mm-hmm. Black men and women going to be sitting here arguing tomorrow still. So that's what I look at. I think about that as far as how we are as a people. And that cave woman told y'all exactly what's on her mind. White life. I don't have a problem with that. I don't want racists to hide their racism. That's a request that black people been making to the caves for, you know, ever, decades. I don't want that. I disagree that we should be wanting them to hide their racism. Come up with better ways to disguise it. I don't want them to do that. But this is a fight between the white man and his mama. That's a fight between them. The cave bitch and her son. That's a fight between them. That's what this is. That's what this is about. And it ain't no Hotep shit for me to say that's what this is about. These are facts. That's what this is about. Let them fight it out. Let them do whatever the fuck they got to do. It's not something that black men and women should be up in arms about. It's not a victory for black men at all. I've seen some black men acting like it was, and we talked about the coon mentality that it takes to even for something to be suggested that may make give a hardship to your woman. You celebrate that. That's trash. That's coon shit. We don't do that shit over here. This is not a something that I feel as though black women should then pick up these white hoes and put them on your shoulders. You've done that too many times already. It's time to stop that. It's time to stop that. And what you'll notice is no matter what the caveman does, the cave bitch gonna stick beside him. And I want y'all to notice that now. This is them making the laws, overturning the laws, doing whatever the fuck they want to do with all these laws, whether it be in these states, state by state. The cave woman still not going to call this motherfucker out by name. She not going to do it. She refuses to do it. Period. Period. Right. Brother Barry said, it's hard conveying this message to these coons. Boy, who you telling? You talking about preaching to the damn choir. Coons and sheep. It's both. Like, you can't, people who trust the government, they're going to go along with whatever the government says, you know, and that's just a sheep mentality as well. It's hard, man. It's hard because the thing is that people don't want to say that fuck the entire system. They want to have little pieces and little bits and pieces that they like and enjoy and that they benefit from. I say fuck the whole thing, right? I'm not going to tell you to go vote because that's dumb. It doesn't work. It doesn't matter. So when you say fuck the system and you really mean that the entire system, you'll have black folk like, nah, man, it's just that y'all ain't voting. That's automatically what black folks say. You can't say fuck the system. It's just because y'all ain't voting. No, okay. And then when you have these fucking feminists come out here and these feminists, these ridiculous, what I put feminists in quotation marks. These ridiculous feminists come out here acting like that it's all men oppressing them. No, it's not. And this is why I don't fuck with feminists, because they're fucking dumb. They're stupid. Because if you have an enemy, you call them out by name. You're not going to keep acting like it's me oppressing you. Like, I'm a black man. I'm not writing the laws. I'm not making the laws. I didn't set your wage. You're not going to keep coming out here yelling at me. You're not going to do that. You can do it. I'm not going to respect it. And that makes your message now not really mean much of a fuck to me, because you won't call your enemy out and your oppressor out by name. I'll call mine out by name. You won't call yours out by name. And it makes me not respect anything you're saying. Now you just sound like a bitter, dumb bitch to me. And I'm just going to be honest about you, about the situation. If you won't call them out by name, you yelling, you screaming, you brave, you can do, you know, what all a man can do. Okay, all of that. Well, then call your motherfucker that you're talking about out by name then. Why ain't you do that yet? I don't believe there's a such thing as feminism, but because all of it would be directed towards the caveman. All of it would be. It just would be. This is why I can't respect feminists. And that's not knocking now. I'm not saying that everything that they're talking about isn't a righteous cause. I don't think women should be paid less than men. I don't think men should be telling women what to do with their fucking bodies. But you need to call the motherfucker out that's doing this shit. Call them out by name. And once you call them out, you speak to everything that they've done and how they're just escalating. Because this ain't the worst thing that the cave or this justice system or these laws, it's not the worst thing they ever done. They just escalating a little bit more now. They escalating a little bit. It's not even, I mean, they scared. They trying to keep their birth rate up. So they're going to escalate a little bit. They're going to force their women to have kids with them, I mean, or give birth to the kids that they don't want. But these feminists will not call these people out by name. They refuse to do it. That's why I don't respect many of the black feminists. I can't respect them because they won't call out their enemy by name. They keep telling me it's me. You're not going to keep telling me it's me, and I'm out here, you know, I'm just going to work and shit, you know, driving trucks. I'm chilling. I ain't thought about taking no rights from you. The motherfucker that's taking your rights from you, you won't call him out by name? You got a problem with calling him out by name? Then I can't respect you. That's how I feel anyway. These are facts. Their eternal gender war drags us into it due to proximity. It's because we want to be just like them. And they gender war, I'm going to tell you what, Jirake, if I'm saying that right, I'm going to tell you what, they gender war is, it's different than ours, because we'll sit here and slam each other by name, you know, black man, black woman, black, we'll slam each other by name. They won't do that. Even when they fight and they do it in a more on code way than we do. We take on their gender war and do it wrong as hell. Just self-hating. Our shit be laced with self-hate and coon shit. And it's like, what the fuck are y'all talking about? Most of the shit that we argue about is it ain't got nothing to do with laws or statutes. Or it ain't got nothing to do with none of that because we don't make no laws. So it ain't even, it's not even based on real shit. It'd be interpersonal shit. You know, it'd be interpersonal. Well, you know, this woman broke my heart. This man broke my heart. Or, you know, something happened where I was in an abusive situation. It ain't got nothing to do with laws and wages. And who stands to win in a court of law? It ain't got nothing to do with none of that. We be arguing about stupid shit. They be actually arguing about wages and shit. How much time should a rapist get? Or, you know what I'm saying? What sexual harassment really is. We be over here arguing about dumb shit amongst both. Neither one of us have any power. Like, how the fuck are you powerless? And I'm telling y'all, it doesn't make any sense. And anybody that's black that will not be real about this with you, they misleading you. I believe that in my heart. Two, black man, black woman, you don't have any power in the system whatsoever, but you sit around yelling at each other all day like you do. Like, you don't. You don't have any power to inflict, or not to inflict, but to change any laws. They may come write some shit in for you to placate to what you may have been saying, like they did with the whole George Floyd law and this, the anti-lynch bill, even though we're still finding black men lynched and they're still saying it's suicide. We don't have power to, we're not writing laws and we're not enforcing them. So what the fuck y'all arguing about? What does it matter what y'all arguing about? Don't matter. Y'all arguing for nothing. Because you can yell at me all day. I don't write no laws. I can yell at you all day. You don't write no laws. So what's the point? It'd be better if we got together and yelled at the motherfuckers that do. But we don't want to do that. It's mind-blowing. It's mind-blowing. Rob, have you talked about Clarence Thomas? I have. I am still trying to understand. Is he removing civil rights? Who the hell is he? He's a Supreme Court justice. And they are trying, they're making him the face of all of this, but he's not acting alone. He's just a coon in the caves that's working with the caves to strip away certain federal mandates, because they're making it about the state. So to be plain and simple, Clarence Thomas is just a Supreme Court justice, and it's not just him. I want to say it was how many of these motherfuckers are? Is it 8-10 of these motherfuckers? They vote, and majority rules. That's basically how this works. And they're saying that when Trump was in there, he got these conservative Supreme Court justices in there, just like Clarence Thomas is. And therefore, when they vote to overturn, the conservative vote won. It's the same game they play when they talk about the Senate and how the Republicans have control of the House. You'll hear that type of rhetoric, or the Democrats have control of the House. They'll say that type of shit, not saying that people who don't give a fuck about human life have control of the House. That's really what it is. Whether it's Democrat or Republican, no one cares about anybody out here. And particularly when we come to black people. So Clarence Thomas is just one of. They're using his face, because he is the one that is black, so they can put him out here and he'll be the whipping boy, because he probably signed a contract that said, well, anytime y'all need my coon ass to come out here and take this heat for y'all, I'll do that. Because one thing that a coon will do is dive on a fire to save the cave's image. They will do it. They will risk their lives to save the cave image. But Clarence Thomas is just one of. Okay. He's the only sitting black man that is a Supreme Court justice, but he doesn't represent black men or women in any type of way. He never has. He's just there. And that's why he's there as well, if that makes sense. So, but he's just one of, he's a so-called conservative. We call him coon conservatives over here. But he's just one of, and they voted and they said, well, fuck it. I know Clarence, look, man, We need our bitches to be forced into having our kids. Our numbers is low. And the only way we're going to keep our numbers high and working and to oppress you in large number is for them to have children at the rate to compete with everybody else. We can't oppress y'all as good if it's more of y'all than it is us. So can you help us out? And just like the faithful coon that he is, he said, well, hell yeah, massa. I got you. I'm tired of these niggas anyway. I don't never want y'all numbers to drop. We need y'all for good law and order and morals. Y'all keep us in check. And that's what happened here. But his face is the one out here. So they're not coming for civil rights per se. Not right now. Anyway, they may. I mean, I don't know. And honestly, I can't even say I care about them coming for civil rights because it's going to take something heavy for people to stand up and you not be the only person walking out your damn job. It's going to take something heavy. So I don't care what they do. I want people to understand that. Anybody listening to this, understand this. I don't care and I'm not afraid. I do not care and I'm not afraid. I don't care what the fuck they doing. It's going to take the heat being turned up for people to move into action. And I'm not talking about violent action. This ain't about violence. This is more actually about inaction. To get rid of that fear, it'll take more. So if they come for civil rights, let them come for them. That maybe that'll move niggas. Maybe that'll move them. I don't know what it's going to take to move black people. I've been trying for the longest. And we've had people that tried before I was even born. Our people are difficult people to move. We're difficult. It's difficult to get us to pay attention to the right things. We pay attention to whatever the caves tells us is important. And that's why we're talking about this now. They said it was important. So we have to carry on the torch and the mantle of, well, we got to make it important to us. As a matter of fact, we're going to argue amongst ourselves about it. That's how silly we are. A lot. But all Clarence Thomas dared to do is they putting his face out there and say, hey, you know, we using his face, so black people go have somebody to attack. He'll be the whipping boy for them. He been getting called a coon so long, he don't even care. But with him, with his face out there, then people can't say, well, America, 3Ks, don't get this shit fucked up, Incorporated, is racist. Or America, 3Ks, don't get this shit fucked up, Incorporated, is being anti-woman. It looks more so like, well, this black man is the one up here trying to call. He causing all these problems. I even saw Martha Stewart call this motherfucker a coon. You know you bad off if a cave hoe is calling you a coon. She didn't call him a coon, but she said something about him not knowing who he is. That's what she said about Clarence Thomas. He done forgot who he is. Like, when she rats around about, she basically called him a coon. Basically calling you a coon, you know, but he don't care. He goes home to his cave wife. She gives him his little coon treats and shit like that, and he's happy with it. I mean, it's Clarence Thomas. Look at his wife. His wife is a raging racist ass bitch, and he laying with this hoe. I mean, so that's who he is. If you want to know who he is, that's who he is. If you want to know why he's there because he's anti-black, just like every other Supreme Court justice that will ever get appointed in history. They all are anti-black. It just is what it is. And even if they're not the ones that may be a little bit less, you know, overt about their anti-blackness, they'll always be outvoted. That's how they play the outvote. They play that vote game. They do that. Well, it was 4-3 or, you know, they'll play that. Just one motherfucker, man. Like, yeah, it was that close because these three motherfuckers in here that care about people. And it's like, what the fuck does that matter? If all motherfuckers in there don't care about people, how are you a Supreme Court and you don't care about, how do you get to use the word Supreme if you don't give a fuck about people and the rights and the freedoms that y'all supposed to be upholding here? How could you call yourself Supreme? It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Well, that's why. That's why, Paris. They want you to focus on him. I've only seen his name about everything. They want you to focus on him because they want you to ignore the rest of them caves that's in there. They want you to ignore all them other caves and focus on him. So it's just, you know, it's a game that they play. you know, they've been planning for a while, and we just have to be conscious of it. And we have to recognize who Clarence Thomas is. He's a career coon. I mean, that's we have to be okay with that and understand that he don't represent us. And the Supreme Court doesn't represent black people in any way. It never has. They never represented us at all. But this, in this situation, the only thing that's happening here is now states have the power to make their own rules about what's illegal in their state. That's all this is. It's you. I'm telling you, you compare it to marijuana. It's the same thing. You may have more states that, you know, outlaw it or, you know, make it lawful or whatever, but it's the exact same. You can use the marijuana template right here with this. And that's one thing that was bothering me with people acting like, you know, it was every state that is completely like it's the same as marijuana. And y'all ain't been mad too heavy about that. And it was like, well, the states divided again. I'm thinking divided again. The states have never not been divided. What it's like people trying to create a reality that ain't real. These states been divided. That's why you can get high as fucking Colorado and get arrested in another state. Like, say, well, South Carolina or something like that. It's been divided. States have their own laws. It's been like that. And now here we have this coming up again where now states are deciding their own laws. Again, it's just about abortion this time. So simmer down a little bit. You can still be mad because the so-called Supreme Court and this so-called justice system is trash, but you should have been mad about that is what I'm saying. Don't be new mad about this. Don't be new mad. You should have been mad. And if you wasn't already mad, you should go back. And if you take a look at what they've been doing, it'll feed more of your anger. Get real mad. But like I said about these cave holes, they ain't been mad about nothing. As far as the institutional and systematic racism that black people have been enduring in this country for centuries, they ain't been mad about none of that. So don't trust them just because they're mad about this. These people are not to be trusted. Those cave holes are not your friend, black woman. I don't want y'all to know that because I know black women are going to be the most vocal about this. They're not your friend. They're not your friend at all. They never have been. And I want you to understand that. Understand that. Boy, who you telling? Jay Bear, who you telling? It is so sad. That's why I look around sometimes and I see people in a panic. And it's like, I mean, there's no need to panic. There's never a need to panic. Just be calm. Understand what you're seeing. Understand the system and what it's trying to do. Understand, you know, enough to have the heart to act if you need to act. Have the mind to teach your children what this government really is about, who these people are, but don't panic. We don't panic around here. And y'all been watching me do this shit for years. To me, people who panic are slow and dumb. That's the ones I consider slow and dumb. Like, I'm not about to panic because I know that's unnecessary and it doesn't do anything. Panic does not do anything. So it's a waste of time. What we need to do is let people know that we see them. Let people know that we see them. We see the games they plan, and it's not going to work. I'm not going to be afraid. And this is whether people is, remember, weren't we just doing World War III? It's just like one thing after another thing after another thing. It's always something to try to keep people off balance, to try to keep you in a state of panic at all times. Nobody panic. When people get mad enough, they'll just stop going to work. That's what I believe. That will be the move. It won't be to hold no signs. It won't be to be screaming or nothing like that in the streets. It'll be to sit their asses down. Women, let me tell you something. This is women, period. You outnumber men. A lot of women are in the workforce. If y'all sit down, just women alone, the teachers, and I'm not talking about just black women. I'm talking about women, period. Even these cave hoes is out here complaining, acting like they are just, you know, going through all this shit and they're so oppressed. Sit your ass down. There goes most of the teachers in school right there in one whop, just with women protesting with their labor. No more. If women just sit down, there's your boycott. There's your protest right there. That's just with the cave hoes. This is how you know cave bitches don't even care about themselves. They don't care. Because a lot of them cave bitches support this shit. They want to be forced to have children because a lot of them know that they ain't gonna be them. So it ain't gonna be them. A lot of them be old bitches like, bitch, your womb is dead. It was on life support. Now you 60 talking about forcing a young girl to have a child. Your womb dead. It ain't even something you gonna have to deal with. You got these old hoes talking about some goddamn, you know, yeah, you know, we with this shit. They shouldn't be wanting to kill these kids. Like, bitch, you're 60. Nobody's fucking with you. Nobody's fucking with you like that. But now you the one that want to force a young girl. Like, get the fuck up out of here. These women, all they have to do is sit down. Even if you're a black woman, you mad, you can go. But I'm tired of them using us. Like, let them do their thing. It's a caveman, cavewoman fight. Let them fight it out. The only way the cavewoman gonna win, though, is if y'all start turning those conversations into boycotting with their labor. Holding signs ain't gonna do shit. And black women, don't waste your time with that. That's a waste. If that's all the cave bitch wanna do, she can go do that on her own, you know, like this. Change isn't going to happen unless y'all stop working. Point blank, plain and simple. Point blank. This is how you cause problems in this system. Period. Okay? And you know, I mean, again, people be telling me I'm tripping, I'm crazy, or whatever, but this is what I see. This is how it looks to me. Black women, do not panic. Do not stand with these white hoes. If all they're going to do out there is stand up and hold signs and scream and yell and, you know, and all this extra. Just don't waste your time with that. That's not gonna make the caveman change the laws. That ain't gonna do nothing. That ain't gonna work. You'll know when they're serious because you'll see millions of women not going to work. That's how you'll know. That's how you'll be able to tell. All right. So y'all listen, I'm about to get the fuck off here. I appreciate y'all coming to spend this time with me. Y'all like the video, share the video. For my team, for my people, have no fear. That's just why I want that to be the main thing that comes from this. Have no fear and let these cave hoes fight their own battles with their man. Let them do that. Okay? We have to be cautious. We have to be vigilant to know what's going on, but we don't let what's going on scare us and knock us off our square. Black women, be more protective and cautious about who you're laying with, who you're having children with. Black men, be more protective and cautious about who you laying with, who you having children with. But that should have been a thing, right? Shouldn't take this for that to become the conversation. That should have been a thing. We got to do better about that. That's real. And they can't fuck with us no matter what. They're the ones dying off. Let them fight about that. Let's not fight amongst each other about their issue, their problem. We just be cautious, be more disciplined, and let these motherfuckers kill each other if they want to do that. But let's see what happens. I'm sure this is going to be something that people continue to talk about, continue to have conversations about, continue to make videos about. We'll see what happens here. Because again, you know, it's something, it's just another thing to me. But we'll watch how it unfolds. I'm not spreading fear to my people. I'm spreading courage. I'm spreading bravery. And that's what I'm trying to feed into my people. That we're not scared over here. That's not what we're doing. And we're not talking about running nowhere to escape, because these white folk out here all over the world, whether the Asian caves and white men, they all out here being anti-black. And it's time for us as a people to be pro us, pro ourselves, pro black, which is something that gets a negative connotation. But right now, the entire world is anti-black. You don't have a choice but to be pro-black. You don't really have a choice, okay? There's no other option. You can talk shit about it, even a whole tip, blah, blah, ha, ha, ha. Well, the whole world's anti-black, sir, ma'am. So you don't have a choice. You don't have a choice, okay? That's all the fuck I wanted to say. Fear not. We good. Just focus. Stay disciplined. Keep your eyes open. And let's see how the fuck this shit pans out, okay? If they come for contraceptive next, that'll be another thing. If they come for sodomy next, that'll be another thing. If they come for gay marriage next, that'll be another thing. That'll be another thing that they're trying to do. And we'll see how far we allow them to go, because it's what the people are allowing. When I say we, I'm not talking about just black people again. Working class, it's what we're allowing them to do. They can't do it without us. And at some point, we're going to have to realize that's true. Okay? We have to. That's all the fuck I want to say, though. Shout out to you, Rob. Y'all know what the fuck it is. Black first, second, and third. And I'll see y'all in the next one. I'm out.